Good afternoon, everybody. You are about to watch Deeper Life Bible Church program, the Moment of Transformation. Today, by the grace of the Lord, we shall listen to our pastor, General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumuyi. You are going to be blessed. It is my wish that you call your family to come and listen to you as our pastor is blessing you with his holiness message. Be blessed.
Listen, I'm going to sow into his life. I don't know him. I'm going to sow into his life. David, you are weeping. Yes, I'm bearing precious seed. And I'm going to sow something into this person's life. That's what I told you. At a time of sorrow, sow something good into other people's life. Because that thing can be the source of the restoration of everything that you have lost in Jesus' name. I want you to look at the next verse there. Verse 12, it says, and they gave him a piece of a cake of figs and two clusters of raisins. And when he had eaten, his spirit came again to him. And then it says, for he had eaten no bread, nor drunk any water, 3 days and 3 nights. In verse 13, and David said unto him, to whom belongest thou? And whence art thou? And he said, I am a young man of Egypt, servant to an Amalekite. And my master left me, because 3 days had gone, I fell sick. But now David administered to him in his own sorrow. And remember, David wept until he had no power to weep again. But even at the time of that sorrow, at the time of that calamity, he was still able to minister, to people. And you will be like that in Jesus' name. And we made an invasion upon the south of Cherethites, and upon the coast which belonged to Judah, and upon the south of Caleb. He began to confess what they had done. And then he said, and we burnt Ziklag with fire. And David said unto him, canst thou bring me down to this company? And he said, swear unto me by God that thou wilt neither kill me nor deliver me into the hands of my master, and I will bring thee down to this company. And when he had brought him down, behold, there was spread abroad upon all the earth eating and drinking and dancing, and because of all the great spoil that they had taken out of the land of the Philistines and out of the land of Judah. And David smote them from the twilight even unto the evening of the next day, and there escaped not a man of them, save 400 young men which rode upon the camels and fled. And David, tell me now, and David recovered all that the Amalekites had carried away. You recover all in Jesus' name. Look at verse 19, and there was nothing lacking to them, neither small nor great, neither sons nor daughters, neither spoil nor anything that they are taking to them. David recovered all. David recovered all. Put your name there. David recovered all. Put your name there. David recovered all. Do that again. You recover all in Jesus' name. Do you see how he recovered all? Because he sowed into that person's life. He was a stranger. That's what I'm saying. This year, don't mind. Don't worry about your problem, about your tears, about your weeping, about your sorrow, about your affliction. Just sow. You sow into somebody's life, and 100-fold will come back to you in Jesus' name. But you know, there are some unwise people. They do not understand. They do not know the law of sowing and reaping. They do not understand it is what we sow that God will multiply, and then he'll bring it back to us. And you are going to prevent this, but I'm going to show you so you know how to prevent it in Jesus' name. We're looking at Deuteronomy chapter 32. Deuteronomy chapter 32, I'm reading there from verse 29. Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 29. Don't allow anything to ever push you this year to sow anything undesirable. Anything that is going to bring sorrow into your life, into anybody's life. Because it is what you sow that you are going to reap. It says in Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 29, oh, that they were wise. That means they are not wise. And God said, oh, that they were wise, that they understood this, that they would have consider their latter end. They would consider the harvest. If they were wise, they'll say, what I'm sowing today is what I'm going to reap in the future. What I sow in January, February, first part of the year is what I'm going to reap at the end of the year. If we are wise, we're going to consider that. But they were not wise. What did they sow? Because they were not wise. Job chapter 4. In Job chapter 4, I read there from verse 8 and verse 9. Job chapter 4, verse 8. Even as I have seen that they that plow iniquity and sow wickedness, what happens? They reap the same. The people that sow wickedness, instead of sowing joy and happiness and love and mercy and goodness, they sow wickedness. They that sow wickedness reap the same. Look at verse 9. By the blast of God they perish, and by the breath of his nostrils are they consumed. The wise, don't sow wickedness this year, don't sow iniquity this year. You are a child of God, sow something good into other people's lives. In Proverbs chapter 6, Proverbs chapter 6, I read there from verse 14. Proverbs chapter 6, we're reading from verse 14. Frowardness is in his heart. He devises mischief continually. He soweth discord. He soweth discord. He knocks heads together. He knocks the head of the wife with that of the husband. He knocks the head of the children with that of the parents. He knocks the head of friends together. He sows discord. And remember, that's not wise, because it is what we sow that we're going to reap. Look at verse 19. A false witness speaketh lies, and he that soweth discord, and he that soweth discord among the brethren. The people that sow division and discord and conflict, that's what you're going to reap. You will not sow that this year in Jesus' name. If you have sown anything of discord and disunity and conflict, uproot it, so that it will not bear fruit in your life this year. And then cover that ground up, and then begin to sow unity, and begin to sow fellowship, begin to sow love. What you sow is what you are going to reap. Look at Proverbs chapter 22. Proverbs chapter 22. There are wise sowers that sow a doomed future, for a doomed future. Proverbs chapter 22. And I'm reading there from verse 8. Proverbs 22, verse 8. He that soweth iniquity shall reap vanity. He that soweth iniquity, the people who sow iniquity to other people's lives, it says, yes, they will reap too, but they're not wise. Because what they reap at the end of the year, they will say, I thought we read the word of God that says God is going to give you a better future, a brighter future, a blessed future, a glorious future. Look at what is happening to me. Well, let's look at what we have been sowing. Because it says, he that soweth iniquity shall reap vanity, and the rod of his anger shall fail. That is, maybe he was angry, and that's why he sowed iniquity. I'm not happy. Because I'm not happy, I'm going to sow iniquity. It says, even the rod of his anger shall fail. Hosea chapter 8. We're looking at verse 7. Hosea chapter 8, verse 7. The Lord is telling us that since this is a year of prophecy for us and year of fulfillment of promise, we should make sure that we sow that which is good, so that every moment of the year and every day of the year, what you sow will bring good fruit and good harvest to your life in Jesus' name. In Hosea chapter 8, we're looking at verse 7. Hosea chapter 8, verse 7. For they have sown the wind, and they shall reap the wild wheat. See that? The people that have storms in their lives, they are raging, the waves raging in their lives. And it's a wild wind. It says, it's their fault. It's their fault. The Lord wanted them to have peace and a calm sea. And he wants them to have calmness and joy and fulfillment. But instead of sowing what is right, they sowed the wind. And now they reap the wild wind. It has no stalk. And then it says, the birch shall yield no meal. If so be it yield, the stranger shall swallow it up. But again, it's their fault. Look at verse 3. Israel has cast off the thing that is good. That is, the message that God gave them, they cast it off. The advice, the counsel, the commandment the Lord gave them, they cast it off. They said, no, we're not going to sow anything good. We're going to sow the wind. And because of that, in verse 3, the enemy shall pursue him. I pray that this year, the enemy would leave you alone in Jesus' name. You know, if somebody is trying to run a race and then all enemies are surrounding him, pulling him back, threatening him, making face to him, saying, no, you will not do it. Or they are shouting. But this year, as you are going to run this race to a prosperous year, to a glorious year, to a wonderful year, all those enemies that pursued it in the past, they're going to go away in Jesus' name. I don't know, maybe this year already they are showing up in the dream. I cancel their power in your life in Jesus' name. You know, but if you don't cast off the message that the Lord is giving us, this good message is giving us, sow something good and sow love and sow mercy in the lives of people. It's what it says, if Israel will continue to cast off that which is good, the counsel that is good, and the commandment that is good, the enemy shall pursue him. And look at what happened to them in verse 12, chapter 8, verse 12. I'm reaching to him the great things of my law. I told him that until the earth remains, as long as the earth remains, the law of sowing and reaping will also always be there. Now, whatever you sow, that's what you are going to reap. That's what I showed them. And it's a great sin of my law, but they were counted as a strange thing. Instead of following after what I wanted them to follow after, they counted as a strange thing. That's why they kept on sowing, and they were sowing things that will not profit them. And then what a calamity came upon them. That will not be your lot this year in Jesus' name. Jeremiah chapter 4. Jeremiah chapter 4. I'm reading from verse 3. For thus says the Lord to the men of Judah and Jerusalem, break up your fallow ground and sow not among thorns. Sow not among thorns. You know, brothers and sisters, there are some people that say, it doesn't matter where I sow my money. It doesn't matter where I give my money. It doesn't matter whether I give it to a drunkard or give it to a smoker. It doesn't matter. Of course, you know it matters. That's why it's saying yes. Even those of us who are saying, I'm going to sow love, I'm going to sow mercy, I'm going to sow some, you know, gifts, I'm going to sow some help in people's lives. It doesn't mean that because you just want to sow, you sow everywhere. The drunkard wants money for more drinks, you give him money. And the, you know, prostitutes wants more money to buy a new dress so that she can go out and look nice to all the people patronizing her. You give her money. And the one that wants to cheat or wants to steal, you give him money to buy what he will use to shoot other people and kill them. You give them money and say, the word of God says, we should sow. And whatever we sow, we're going to repay. You will sow into the right place. Other people say, I'm going to give my tithes and offering. And it doesn't matter where I give my tithes and offering, in a syncretic church where they're not preaching the word of God, in an idolatrous place where they're not preaching the gospel. Anyway, I just want to give my offering. I distribute. I give some here. I give some. No. It says, do not sow among the thorns. Let me show you. Mark. In Mark chapter 4. Mark chapter 4, where we sow, even when we sow something good and something precious and something wonderful, where we sow is very, very important. We're reading from Mark chapter 4, verse 3. Mark chapter 4, verse 3. Hearken, behold, there went out a sower to sow. There went forth a sower to sow. Look at verse 7. It says in verse 7, and some fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it, and it yielded no fruit. That means then, we're to be wise. This year, we're going to sow. I said this year, we're going to sow. For example, now here am I am sowing the word of God into your life. What if I didn't come here today and you were all there ready to receive the word of God, ready to believe the word of God, and then there's another place, you know, they call me there, and those people, all they want is just for me to tickle them, all they want for me is just to, you know, entertain them. They're not interested in the word of God like you are, like you are interested. And I just say, well, the important thing is to preach. Whether I'm preaching to people who are going to hear, like, you know, people here, or I'm preaching over there to people who don't want to hear anything, it doesn't matter, just to preach. No, the Lord is saying that this year you will spend your time wisely, you'll spend your money wisely, you will spend everything you've got, you spend it wisely in Jesus' name. That's why it says some fell among thorns. The things you are sowing this year will not fall among the thorns. Look at the interpretation of that in verse 18 and verse 19. It says, these are they which are sown among the thorns, such as hear the word, and the cares of this life, and the deceitfulness of riches, and the lust of other things entering in, choke the word, and becometh unfruitful. Therefore, you want to make sure that wherever you are sowing what you are sowing, it will bear fruit. I said it will bear fruit, but make sure that you are wise and you are sowing in the right place, and God will bring the fruit to your life in Jesus' name. I come to point number 3 now, watchful sowers securing a desirable future. I'm sure that you have already written down some things you desire this year. I said you're writing down the things you desire this year. Spiritually, professionally, domestically, in your family, the Lord is going to bring it to pass in Jesus' name. Psalm 37. I'm reading from verse 4. Psalm 37, verse 4. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. Write those desires down. What do I want to be spiritually this year? And what do I want to be economically, financially this year? What do I want to be in my profession this year? What do I want to do? What do I want to achieve this year? How much do I want to contribute to the kingdom of God this year? Put all those desires down. Do I want to raise a family this year? Get married this year? Have children this year? Do I want to make progress in my work this year? Have all those desires written down. It says, then delight yourself also in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart. Look at verse 5. Commit thy way unto the Lord. After you have shown all those desires, you say, that's what I desire. This is what I want. Then you commit all your ways to the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. It has happened already. I said it has happened already. That means, but now we need to be watchful. Look at this. We need to be watchful. Matthew chapter 13. Matthew. We're looking at 13 verse 24. Matthew chapter 13. I'm reading from verse 24. Another parable put ye forth unto them, saying,